Hello, beloved ones, and welcome to an incredible energy update for April 2024. I'm Matt Kahn.
And I'm Joy Kahn.
And we are the Kahns. This is the first time that we are doing a transmission where Joy Kingsborough is now Joy Kahn. And I just want to take this moment to thank all of you for your well wishes and such beautiful words of support for our recent marriage. And I just want to say thank you. And we love you. And we're so excited to be here with you during this most incredible time in history.
Yes. What a treat this is.
Speaking of treats, you know, this month is filled with so much incredible energy and activity. And I just, you know, I love how both of us, Joy, have such a complementary transmission that offers such perspective for these incredible emerging times. And with all of the energy that's moving in for April 2024, I would love if you could share what's coming through your transmission to start off this energy update.
Yeah, I love that. Thank you so much, Matt. And what a, you know, when you're, we say, what a treat. I think that over time, we come to experience these monthly energies as a gift. And I think that's why we're all drawn to listen in, to connect in with what's happening astrologically, numerologically, and what we're picking up from a channel perspective. It gives us some insight into all of the things that we're feeling. And I think everyone, especially in the last, you know, 5, 7, maybe 10 years, there's been an amplified awareness that so much is changing and so much is happening. And so we come together in this forecast, this energy update, feeling the intensity of a time when we've been sort of waiting, we've been witnessing, or sort of that feeling of waiting with bated breath, like you're waiting to exhale. You know something is unfolding. It's been unfolding for a long time. And here we come into an energy that from a numerological perspective and from an astrological perspective has massive implications. So numerologically, we're feeling the energy of amplification. We're being guided by the energy of the number three. This particular month is focused on the three energy, which means we're going to be seeing threes everywhere. We're going to be seeing things in threes. And the three is going to be talking to us in a way that helps us to amplify our understanding. So it amplifies what we're thinking. It amplifies what we're feeling, but it also amplifies what we're experiencing in the world, sort of brings things to a head. It brings things forward in a way that we've been on some level really hoping for. And on another level, we might be feeling a little bit of uncertainty about. And so that sensation in the body that we're feeling as we come to the close of March and open up into April is an acceleration of the knowingness inside of us that's also connected to the not knowing, the uncertainty of these times. So there's an amplified sense that something is happening, and it's going to be really present, especially from the first through the 24th. So the first several weeks of the month, we're going to be feeling this slowing down of our awareness, where we're really present to what's happening, but perhaps a speeding up or an accelerating of things coming to a rapid close. And a lot of that is occurring because we're experiencing the final push or the final energy of an eclipse, of a significant eclipse. So I want to talk a little bit more about that as we continue, but I just want to start off with this sense of what it is to sort of be waiting to exhale and then inviting us to exhale, even if we don't know all that's unfolding or why it's unfolding, but allow ourselves to kind of come into that peace and ease within ourselves. And rather than brace for these changes, welcome them and learn to ease and relax our body, if that makes sense.
It certainly does. And it's such a complimentary introduction to what I tune into. And you talk about things happening in threes and stepping into the unknown. And when I tune into the energies of what you're transmitting, I get that there is a theme that this month, because of course, when we talk about the energies, what we are really wanting to offer to each and every one of you is how can you make the most of the energies of this month, right? It's never the intention to share these energy updates so that you have to kind of endure the energies of the universe so that you're a victim of circumstances. Instead, it's to empower and educate so that you can make the most of every theme of every month so that no matter what happens in the planet, no matter what happens on a political or socioeconomic level, you have the awareness of how you can use this month and this time to propel your consciousness, to expand your reality, to elevate your vibration, and to take quantum leaps in the direction of your highest mastery. And enjoy, when you speak of the number three and stepping into the unknown, those two ingredients for me create a perfect recipe that April 2024 is an incredible month to allow yourself to steep and align and connect with your higher self, perhaps in a way more than ever before. You know, when we live on a planet during a time where the economy seems to be in a volatile state, when countries are at the brink of incredible conflict, when we're not quite sure in the media what narratives and messages to be able to trust, right? This creates this sense of being in the unknown. But it's only the unknown when we are trusting the earthbound reality as tangible reflections of trying to orient where we are in time and space. But where we truly are in time and space is dependent upon where we are in our journey of communing with our higher self and where we are in our relationship with our highest living potential. And so in this month, where everything is happening in threes, where things seem the most uncertain, right? It could be easy to say, I feel overwhelmed. I want to hide. I want to withdraw. I want to play out my patterns that veil as coping mechanisms. But the real invitation of this month is to say, maybe instead of the things that I may have done during the most tumultuous times like COVID, how can we use this month and the uncertain energy that all of these factors are bringing to us to step into our highest level of mastery? And one of the ways I want to describe mastery, and I'll probably have a few different ways of describing it through this energy update, is that mastery is an opportunity. And even if you looked at this month as just like a social experiment to bring into your life, mastery is an opportunity to be neither attached to being afraid of the lower experiences, nor attached to needing and relying on higher experiences to soothe and free you. And so if we all sat here right now and said, how can I experience connecting to my higher self in this moment? Well, what would it be like in this moment if we were welcoming of higher possibilities, but we're no longer reaching or gripping for them? What if we didn't need to know our desires or even focus on our desires or even envision our desires in order for them to manifest in the way they're meant to anyway? What if we could let go of being in charge of what we desire? And what if we could let go of thinking it's our job to move in the direction of that, even if it's just in this moment? And can we notice that when there's less of a grip on being in charge of desire, or when you're less in charge of needing to keep yourself up or feel one specific way, there also can be more of a peace and a serenity with lesser experiences? And so what if in the month of April, as a way of connecting more with your higher self, because the beginning invitation of connecting with ascended masters and archangels and celestial beings is to make connection with the higher dimensional realms. But the potential of that is to then begin merging into the reality of your higher self so that your highest dimensional version of yourself can start moving into this body And that higher vibrational you can start transforming your reality and the circumstances of others as we fulfill our destiny to be a living doorway, an open doorway for the light of divinity to enter this planet. So in the name of being an open doorway instead of a closed window, what does it feel like if we were neither attached to needing things to be one specific way or needing to constantly envision higher or better possibilities and could also be at peace with whatever possibility emerges? What is it like when I'm neither afraid of the low or attached to the high? And just feel that in your body for a moment. I'm neither thrown by the lows. I'm not seduced by the highs. Now, when you feel the energy, because I can feel you all feeling what I'm transmitting, the fear is if I'm not obsessing about the highs, they may not manifest. That's assuming your ego's in charge of manifesting. So we're going to put that belief aside. The other fear is if I'm okay with the lows, I'm going to manifest more lows. That's not really how the universe works. To think the universe would think, well, you're okay with the lows, so you must want more of that. The universe is infinite intelligence. The universe is infinite mind, infinite heart, infinite reality. The universe would never think in such oversimplified ways. That's just what we project onto the universe as a way of justifying and validating why it's okay to turn away from the less so that we can somehow raise the likelihood of manifesting the more, which is just what we do when we use our imagination as a coping device. So perhaps in just this first part of this energy update, April is a chance to take a break from using your imagination as a coping device. It's a chance to come out of hiding as more of an embodied version of your higher self. And what does it feel like if we spend this month, no matter what you see on the news, no matter what you see in your communities, no matter what you sense, or no matter what people are discussing, or no matter what unfolds, what is it like if in this month our spiritual focus is, I'm neither afraid of the lows, nor am I seduced by the highs. I'm just going to abide in the middle as the higher self that I am now, for myself, for my loved ones, and for the liberation of all sentient beings. I'm neither afraid of the lows. I'm neither seduced by the highs. I'm just abiding in the middle as the higher self that I am. And of course, if there is a fear of lows, we love that part. If there's a part that can't help but be seduced by the highs, we love that part. And we allow ourselves to come back to the middle and allow your higher self, your true nature of ascended mastery, to move greater into this form during this month of April.
Just taking that in for a moment as I feel the wisdom of that moving in through the field, but I also feel it moving through our field and directing the conversation and opening up to the experience of, I think what I loved was when you were talking about the doorway.
Yes.
And well, there were so many things I love about what was coming through you. Mm-hmm. I love the doorway. And I love the experience of seeing ourselves sort of moving with life rather than being bombarded by the highs or lows, by the pull to seek something or the desire to flee something, right? To try to escape it or to try to reach for it and rather come into partnership with life. And that's always our most ideal place to be, is when we see ourselves in that partnership. When we're partnering with what's happening in the world, but also what's happening through us, what's happening through these bodies, and that we are all moving through this universal flow of awakening, which in universal terms is also translated as an evolution. The universe is designed to flow in an evolutionary state. And so by being with and partnering with life, being with life, we are naturally moving in an evolution, similar to how we can't feel how fast the earth is moving, right? Mm-hmm. I think we listened recently to the earth is moving at 1,000 miles an hour, but we don't feel it because we're moving with it. We're not moving against it. We're not fighting the current of the movement and the rotation of the planet. We're moving with it. And so we're moving rapidly. The same thing is true for awakening, for our ascension journey, for the shifts and changes that are happening in our life. We're moving through on this trajectory of evolution, this trajectory of ascension, and we measure it with astrology and we measure it with numerology. We measure the movement, just like we measure the rotation of the earth. And so when we open up to these flows, we get to understand that one of the things that's happening for April that's so profound, that's happening through us, with us, for us, is this open door of this eclipse that's creating a rapid shift that's been unfolding for us this whole time. We didn't need to do anything but to be with it. And it began in 2017. We had a significant evolutionary occurrence, a doorway that opened. And we were all guided through it, whether we realized it or not, whether we had this information or not. We were being guided through it. It began in 2017 with a full solar eclipse that happened over several parts of the world, but a significant portion of North America. And in April, on the 8th, we're going to have another eclipse, full solar eclipse, that's happening over North America again. This is something that doesn't normally happen for 350 years, but because of the design of the universe and the decision of the universe to create an evolutionary moment for all of humanity, it's occurring in a much smaller window of time, over 7 years. And so we're coming to the close of this particular doorway. So we opened up to change. Whatever opened up in you in 2017, whatever that awakening was, maybe awakening to things happening in the world, things happening in your life, whatever that was, you were being moved through that door, whether you realized it or not. And so you moved toward something and moved away from something else without any efforting, just by being where you are and being who you are. And so we're going to be feeling that door close while it simultaneously opens to an even bigger experience. So that story is coming to a close. The story of that shift, of that awakening, that layer of it. And yet it's propelling everyone into this next doorway. And so we're likely to see some rapid changing. Some rapid changing of ideas, of feelings. Maybe something you felt strongly about, you now realize you may have been holding on to, or being stubborn or resistant in that change, feeling something change, not noticing, but by just letting go or stepping back and being with it, not needing anything to change, not needing to reach something else, you actually watch how the feelings just change on their own. You're able to watch them transmute. You're witnessing this shift. So for me, what's coming through incredibly, I would say strong is an understatement. But what I feel for everyone listening in right now is the presence, the sacredness of this particular transition between the beginning of the month into the eighth of the month. And likely for months beyond this, you're going to be feeling the residue, but it's going to be incredibly potent for the beginning of the month, is to witness the change rather than try to do anything to prepare for it or be ready. The preparation is your presence. Yeah. The preparation is our presence right now. And I feel this amplification of even that, of so many people feel like they're right here and present, and we're all going to take that to a whole nother level.
And what's so amazing about that invitation to greater presence, which, you know, I love how our transmission just dovetails so perfectly together, is I want to, and there's so many things coming through the transmission that we're both going to share today, which I'm so glad. Such a juicy transmission for April. Is something I want to share is that, let's think of 2017, which is when the first big solar eclipse happened that you were talking about, Joy. 2017 was a time, and when I say this, I'm telling a story about the evolution of the collective, right? And what makes it so sometimes confusing is that when we give forecasts for the collective energies, it can wax and wane in terms of how you are evolving as an individual. There are individuals on this planet that are evolving far beyond the pace of the collective. There are people that are evolving at the pace of the collective, and there are people that are catching up to the pace of the collective. And so as you hear what we're transmitting, we have to really feel our way into how does that apply to you? And of course, as always, we invite you to use your intuition to always know how these messages are designed perfectly to be gifts the universe are providing you as you watch this. So in 2017, we had this major solar eclipse that signified an opportunity in the collective where the collective would begin a monumental shift out of the third dimension and into fourth dimension, right? And people will say fourth dimension is the dimension of time, but from a spiritual perspective, fourth dimension really signifies an acceleration of spiritual expansion. And what happens in the collective is instead of the third dimension falling away and the fourth dimension taking its place, the third dimension kind of moves from the foreground to the background, and the third dimension does, and the fourth dimension kind of starts to emerge. And so over the last many years, since 2017, there have been people on this planet that have become less and less attached to their third dimensional patterning, or in fact, for most people, they would say they become more aware of their patterning, more desiring of healing their conditioning, and just become more sensitive to the patterns in themselves and other people that emanate from a third dimensional alignment. And this greater awareness of being sensitive to the patterns that used to run you, for most of us, it would show up as the sensitivity of how other people's patterns can trigger our reactions. That's a sign that the planet as a whole is being infused with more spiritual acceleration or greater awareness. And so for the last many years, while there have been many beings that are wanting to move out of 3D and wanting to move into 5D, it really begins by experiencing 3D from an accelerated, more expansive level of awareness. And so here we are in 2024, where we're more aware of 3D on an individual and collective level than we have ever before. And what this eclipse really signifies the beginning of. So if you imagine, here's 3D, it was in the foreground, now it's in the background, and here's 4D to give us greater awareness. Now we begin the process of our attachments to 3D dissolving, so 4D can continually expand our awareness into our collective trajectory into the fifth dimension. It's no doubt that there are many of us that are already living in the fifth dimension, but on a collective level, what this solar eclipse represents for my transmission is the parting of ways, the breaking up with, the dissolving, the death, the unraveling of our attachment to the third dimension. Because what's interesting when we develop spiritual egos, and when you enter fourth dimensional energy, you, on a positive level, become very aware of the 3D patterning. But it's also the case where your 3D patterning continues to get played out through a spiritual ego, which means we just develop spiritual reasons to play out our 3D patterning and mechanisms of defense and coping mechanisms. So in regular 3D, we just have human reasons and human justifications for these patterns. In 4D, we start to develop spiritual reasons to be spiritually aware, but still play out our patterning. So it's kind of like 1 foot in conditioning and 1 foot in liberation. So this eclipse represents the dissolving of our attachment to the third dimension on a collective level. So if you imagine as an individual, your attachment to the third dimension starts to drop in your body. But then what drops in your body starts to elevate in your perspective of the world. And this is what also confuses people, because they say, if I'm releasing my attachment to the third dimension, how come the outside world seems to be going haywire? How come it seems like the world seems to be acting in a rapidly more egocentric way? I thought we were ascending. So if you understand the energies, what drops in the individual starts to elevate in the collective. And then as we witness and experience the elevating of three-dimensional patterning, because what's dropping in the individual elevates in the collective, almost like the last grand finale of the 3D on its way out. And if we can take this month of April to witness and move through these experiences of how 3D patterning that's perishing and unraveling inside your body is going to actually play out in the external world, that's going to look like amplified conflict between countries. That's going to look like volatility in the stock market. That's going to look like the exposure of corruption. That's going to look like people we thought were one way were the other way. And if you're still attached to the 3D, it could really get you pretty resentful, disengaged, and cause you to shut down. Because in the 3D, we're always looking through the lens of fairness. We're not looking through the eyes of evolutionary expansion. So in this month, we're going to experience a solar eclipse, which is where we start to say there's so much 4D expansion inside of us. We need to release our attachment to the 3D to let that expansion continually move the collective into a 5D perspective of unity consciousness. So that means that you are going to be experiencing the world with the invitation to do it with less coping skills and more alignment with your higher self. So this is an opportunity to breathe through each moment, to anchor the grace of universal will, and to realize that it's intentional. And I love how you said it, Joy, that the universe has created this experience for all of us. And if we think about it, how cleverly or how precisely did the universe invent timelines in order for these eclipses to happen in this sequence to give human beings the opportunity to evolve in this way? So when we see what happens in the world, it sometimes may not be the most positive thing to perceive if we're seeing through the viewpoint of personal narrative. If we're seeing through the old programming of I have to avoid the lows and strive for the highs, we fail to see that this is all an evolutionary gift that is helping you release attachment, which means I don't find my safety, my sovereignty, or my stability on the ups and downs of the world. I find my safety, stability, and sovereignty in my breath, in my unwavering connection to the divine. That is not an emotional state. It's not a mental pattern. It is the I am that I am. And as we slow down and say, I will watch the world say goodbye or begin to say goodbye to its attachment to the third dimension. And I will understand that what plays out in the world is the last hurrah of our attachment to 3D that we say thank you to, because you can't get to the next highest step in the staircase without the one before it. If we only had a staircase with the higher steps, we'd have to jump and pull ourselves up and we wouldn't make it. We need each step. So we needed 3D, but we're coming to a place where our attachment to 3D individually and now collectively is becoming obsolete. And we're stepping more into the mastery of spiritual expansion. And we will continue beyond this eclipse to unravel the spiritual ego and to integrate our higher self into physical form. And so again, as the 3D attachment starts to drain out of you, it starts to elevate in front of you or externally in your outside world. Just like for a lot of us, when we wake up, we go, how come I'm waking up? My family feels crazier. Because what is releasing out of you, one individual, starts to take shape in the external world, so that instead of having a first person point of view, you can experience it with a little bit of distance from the second person point of view. And so all of the attachments and patterns that we are releasing individually, that this eclipse is heralding more 4D and moving us into greater alignment with 5D on a collective level, that means that release of 3D attachment must elevate in the world. And from April and a few months beyond is going to create quite a show. But if we understand the instructions that I'm going to witness the show with greater faithfulness and spirit and find my stability, sovereignty, and safety in my breath and in the higher self that is always one with the I am that I am. And if I know that everything is always going in the direction of ascension, oneness, and peace, and as we move through the story of polarity, we're only moving through chaos with greater awareness so that we can create space for a more aware and awake world to be reborn. These are the times we've been training for. These are the times that we've been preparing for. And these are the first steps through the chaos that we get to do with greater awareness and greater mastery and joy, as you said, greater presence. So again, as we release the attachment to the 3D, we simply momentarily watch it arise in the world. And we say, thank you, 3D attachments and patterns, for taking shape in the world, for giving me the opportunity to move into greater alignment with the master that I am. And we do it slowly. We don't try to control our journeys. We are simply surrendered to being loving, heart-centered, willing participants in a journey that we don't have to be in charge of. It unfolds one day at a time. And all we have to do is face forward and say, what is the opportunity I'm being given right now to be more faithful, to be more open, to be more loving, and to be more guided by the grace that is the breath that I breathe.
The releasing of attachment, you can feel that. So many have been getting practice at releasing this attachment.
Yeah.
And yet it's not an avoidance of being with and participating, like you said.
Yes.
Really participating with this experience, understanding that as it's so orchestrated, you know, you mentioned we'll have an opportunity collectively, for sure, and individually, but that collective shift into 4D, we're going to get a small window to integrate that change. And then collectively, there's another acceleration cycle with another eclipse cycle beginning in 2027. So when we think about it from that perspective, being able to see these very precise cycles that have been designed for us there's no need to be in a hurry because it's already accelerated. It's already moving. And so the presence and the releasing of attachment and the invitation to participate is a participation of our presence. It's a participation of being with it and taking action as it comes into our awareness. As something shows up, we take action, right? If something's, you know, if something, I always say when we're driving, if something's on the road in front of us, we move, right? We don't become detached or avoidant. We are paying attention, we're present, and we're responding. And in that response, recognizing that we're being moved through this time. And if we can have that level of release or the letting go of attachment all month long, and so many of the invitations that have come through the field for really honoring that individual release of the detachment, allowing people to be sort of in their chaos as they're awakening out of 3D, as they're awakening into 4D, and as then we let go of 4D into the future, recognizing that as we hold space and it sort of drops into the collective, you know, I love how Matt, you were saying it begins to amplify what's happening collectively. There comes a time when the collective also benefits from our presence and that peace, which happens during this integration that's coming. So our presence will translate into a collective shift as well. It won't always be that we're witnessing this chaos. It's just part of what's happening now. And so really honoring that, and just like the cycles of, you know, we talked about the new moon and the solar eclipse, there's the full moon at the end of the month. So the full moon comes in and says, I'm going to complete part of this cycle for you individually. And we're going to complete some of these cycles collectively. We're going to expose things. We're going to show things to others. We're going to bring things into the collective in a more significant way in order to help ease the collective and move it through the chaos faster. And it brings that chaos into the collective, not for more of it, but the acceleration and the intensification is to actually get it to peak. And as it peaks, then we move into the valley, right? We move into the other side, which so many people are craving. Why can't we be there? Why can't we look away from what's happening in the world so that I can experience peace? It's by looking at it, being with it, and allowing it to amplify and to allow the universe to be in this state of amplification that we move to the valley, right? We move to those years of peace that we've all sensed is possible and is coming. So I love how we can experience that individually and on a micro level each month. From the new moon to the full moon, we experience the amplification of energy and then the waning of energy and the release of something. And we experience that in this micro dose that then becomes the collective macro dose of change. And I really do feel that we're coming to some very peak moments that for me really ring true to that. And if we move through this, this peak will rise and fall quickly and intensely, but it will fall away just as intensely and come into a nice long, it feels like a slow stride into more peace in the coming years. And so you're going to experience that individually, sort of that peace that comes in individually. And as you experience that in yourself, remember that the collective is sort of, I hate to use the word catching up, but it is, it's on the heels of it, but it's got to go through its intense awakening, just like we did individually. And of course it will be bigger. But I think we can expect this month to come in with intensity and exit with intensity. But I think that wave is going to bring in incredible sustainability for the next stages when we move into May. So I think this is sort of that, it's like the push of delivery of a new experience, if that makes sense. I don't know how you're feeling that, Matt, but I'm just feeling this moving through the intensity, knowing that it's going to be captured within this month.
Well, I absolutely agree. And it actually makes me think of a very funny way of distilling this, you know, from an energetic standpoint. If we imagined rain as energy, you know, April showers brings May flowers. And so it's literally, from an energetic standpoint, we're witnessing this, although when it plays out in the storyline of life, it happens to be a lot more intense. And, you know, it doesn't help us to oversimplify it, but to have this awareness. And something you said, Joy, that I really, really loved is you talked about peaks and valleys. And I want to really emphasize this point. And I think, as an aside, it's really going to help a lot of us. A lot of, you know, when you listen to these transmissions, it's not just what we're saying, although that's important too. But the energy you're feeling as you watch it is really kind of giving you the energetic preparation for what's going to come in this month. But when we talk, when Joy, you talked about the energy needs to peak before we can move into the valley. So the peak is the intensity and the valley is the piece that comes after the intensity. And how helpful is it for so many of us in the world that, you know, may have been indoctrinated by old spirituality, which is not its fault because it's just levels of revelation. But how many of us have been under the impression of, oh, I'm not aware that energy needs to peak before I enter the valley. So I make peaks and valleys about worthiness. Oh, I haven't entered the valley because I must not be worthy enough. I must not be good at manifesting myself into the valleys. I guess I have too many thoughts that keep me at the peak and prevent me from the valley. Oh, I have too many reactions and feelings. And how many of us have been working in this ultra puritanical way in the peak, unaware of the technical information that you have to experience a peak peaking before, like a dam busting through, it actually leads you to the valley? And how many of us have taken the time of experiencing individual and collective peak, reaching its peak, and thinking the reason I'm still here is because of something I either am not doing right or must be doing wrong? And can this information that Joy just offered help free us all? That it's not because of something you haven't done well. It's not because of something you continue to do wrong. The energy has to reach a certain peak, and then the tipping point guides us from the peak into the valley, which is just part of the cycle of evolution and not something that you're personally doing wrong or need to do more correctly. And that, I find, as you just said that, I thought, God, how many people are going to be liberated by that? That we're actually learning about the mechanics of the universe, and that it's for the time it takes to go from peak to valley, you have the free will to use your imagination as a coping mechanism to say, I'm going to imagine it's my fault this hasn't happened. I'm going to imagine it's something I haven't done right. I'm going to imagine it's something I keep doing wrong. And that's literally what our free will is capable of doing with the time it takes to reach the peak and go to the valley, which is also unnecessary now that you know that. So you can ride the wave from peak to valley and not make it about you. It's about evolution. And we are here on this planet holding space for the world's ascension. And we don't have to do it with as much 3D interpretation or attachment. And when I say attachment, because I said that earlier, and some people might go, what do you mean by attachment? Attachment means I need life to be a certain way and not anything different. And if it's one way, I'm a nice, loving, thoughtful being. And if it's anything less, I either lash out or I shut down. And so this is how the world is growing into spiritual maturity. that everything is the way it is because it's how the universe needs it to be to push us over the tipping point, to reach us, to push beyond the peak. And then when the tipping point occurs, we all surf the wave into the valley of peace and greater renewal. And the work we do, or the choices we make to align with our mastery, with our higher self, to practice what it's like to neither fear the lows or be seduced by the highs. That in itself is going to help you push over the peak and into the valley, which is going to occur at the exact moment it's meant to. But instead of sitting back and just letting it happen or trying to be in control of anything, again, mastery is being in the middle. And the middle says, I take this month of April as an invitation to align with my higher self. I neither blame myself for the peak that is peaking. I'm neither responsible for the valley I find soon thereafter, but I take it upon myself to use my choices to be less fearful of the lows and less seduced by the highs, so I can take my next big leap forward into the embodiment of my higher self, not only for my growth and expansion, but to support the awakening, revelation, and remembrance of all beings around me. And feel that for a moment. And something else I wanted to share that was coming through, but I really wanted to touch on that first, Joy, because I thought that that was fundamentally such an important piece, that the way you phrased it, I really wanted to make sure that we're all being very aware of the implications of that statement. It's very, very revealing. But in addition to that, and in support of that, in support of releasing your attachment to the 3D and doing it with grace, because again, what gets us so tied up in knots is often if we do it too quickly, it's the 3D patterns that are trying to let go of the 3D attachments. And that just keeps you cycling in 3D. So as a way of helping you releasing your attachment to 3D, as a way of helping you be less afraid of the lows and less seduced by the highs and any fear that that brings up, like I'm not going to manifest good things or I'm going to be stuck in these lower levels, here's something I want to bring through about evolutionary cycles, which of course you, Joy, talk so eloquently about. One of the biggest misunderstandings we have on the planet, or what I'll say is an understanding we have in the third dimension that starts to really change in the fifth dimension, is that we are under a third dimensional impression that birth is followed by death. We are taught that sunrise leads to sunset, day becomes night. And that is partially true. But what happens is if we start with birth, then leads to death, you then have so much you're afraid to lose, and you fear death is the unknown, and it becomes an enemy instead of an ally of evolutionary expansion. So here's what I want to share with you as a different way of looking at it. Let's call it a 5D way of looking at it. Nothing I just said about day goes to night, sunrise, sunset, that's all true, but it's not where the story starts. Kind of like you watch a movie and then a prequel comes out and you go, oh, I thought it started at that movie. It actually started before. What actually starts the cycle, and this may not make sense cognitively, but the beginning of a cycle is death. And from death, we create the space for the renewal of birth. Then from the renewal of birth, it peaks, there's a valley, there's a death, and it creates more room for birth, and the cycle continues. So for example, when you say, my life began when I was born, your life began, and a lot of us would say, oh, in past lives and all these other things, but your life began in the womb. And it was the death of your experience in the womb that brought you into the world. So the first experience we have is death, the dissolving of what we think is our home, which is the womb, being in the womb of the Divine Mother. And then we enter the world of awareness and sight and sound, stimulation. And then we experience things coming and things going. But we're so afraid of losing because we think it begins with a gain. But we have to create the sacred space in order for gain to arise. So in order for your family and your world to have gained a family member to be born, in order for you have gained to have gained a family and a world, for better or for worse, the experience in the womb had to dissolve. So it began with a death. And then we come into the world. And if it started with death, that means we come into the world with nothing, and everything from that point forward is a gain of abundance. And even the loss of experiences is insight gained, which means even when you lose, you gain. So it's always an experience of abundance. But you can see it so clearly if it starts with death and then goes to birth and then so forth after that. If you start with birth and you start with gain, the only place to go is loss. And that's why most people in this world are so afraid and are so separate and live addicted to coping mechanisms, because they've been taught it began with a birth. It starts with a death that clears the space for renewal to be born. Like, even if we go by a book that says, in the beginning, there was the word. But before the word, what would there have to be? The breath. The breath was the death that cleared the space for the word to be born. And so if it starts with a death and then goes to birth, the next death or the next loss or the next dissolving starts to be seen as the way life is and how the universe is constructing gains and losses, only because it's the very force to bring you to the next highest level of your awareness, sovereignty, and mastery. So feel in your body when it's not, it starts with a gain and ends with a loss, or it starts with a birth and ends with death. But we reverse that a little bit. It starts with a death. The death clears the space, creates a sacred ground for something to be born. Just like a flower doesn't begin with the planting of a seed. It begins by fertilizing the soil, preparing the space for the seed to be born. And if loss, if death, if emptiness, if beingness is where things begin, then things going back to beingness and going through a cycle is actually just the movement of evolution, not your fault, not shitty manifestation skills, not bad luck, not poor karma, just our inability to understand the cycles of expansion, because we've been taught and trained to use our imagination as a coping device. Feel this revelation. Because if you came to this planet with nothing, and that's where it began, then moments where we experience loss is just a chance to reconnect with the beginning, to return back to our most natural, innocent state. And of course, any loss is only creating space for greater gains to be given. So of course, we learn at a certain point, no matter what I lose or what doesn't go my way or what doesn't pan out, is only creating space for greater gains to be. And that's why the hands always remain open. Open to receiving, open to giving, and letting the will of the universe move its highest evolution through you. Again, this happens with less attachment. Less attachments to tracking your gains and hiding from losses, defining your self-worth and value by what you have versus what you don't, or trying to present yourself as a series of masks that you hope will earn the approval of others, nor are we trying to sabotage our relationships with others. We're simply all holding space and honoring everyone's unique journey as they learn about the cycles of expansion that play out through our personal lives, that as we wake up out of using our imagination as a coping skill or a coping device, we don't have to overly personalize. We can just ride these beautiful waves, not from birth to death, but starting in death, evolving to birth, experiencing death as the cycle continues.
I love how poetic your description is, especially when I think about, you know, really summarizing this month and why it's so intense. You know, we talked about all the treats this month has, and we've been talking about these different elements, and yet the death that's occurring is really being represented by that eclipse. We're blacking out the sun to represent the birthing of what's next. Right.
That's
so we're literally doing this, and we're layering these cycles. So we have the cycles, the bigger cycle that's unfolding, the bigger peak of this eclipse window from 2017 to 2024. We have that peak coming to a close in the valley, the other side of that, while we have the individual peak and valley, while we have even bigger cycles that are unfolding. But we all can look back, and I could hear people as you were talking, I could hear them reflecting on, wow, but the last several years, if I look back at 2017 to today, it feels like it's all been peak. And that's true.
Mm-hmm.
And so as we experience the completion of some of those elements and the beginning of other amplification, I just really love how you brought that wisdom into the celebration of those completions as being such a, that's the gift. That's actually the gift that makes space for everything else. And evolution, and what I call entropy and you call death, same thing, is always happening simultaneously. And there's that same sacred moment, and the honoring of it in the same equality is, I think, one of those things that allows us to anchor into the presence. When we're not, because I think that's the even bigger implication of what you said about we're not moving away from something or moving towards something that's better, that there it's happening at the same time.
Yes.
I love that so much.
Oh.
Yeah, beautiful.
I love everything. I love everything we're sharing, and I love this transmission. And I think just the weaving of the masculine and feminine and how we transmit, I think, is helping people to go through some, you know, clearings and simultaneous activations so that we can all really have the most conscious experience of what April will be, as April showers brings May flowers. And what I would love to do, just to bring all this together, Joy, and I would love for you to join me in a time-honored,
yes,
good old-fashioned repeat after me.
Let's do it, my love.
An old-fashioned repeat after me. I accept that the intensity of April 2024 is pushing the collective to an evolutionary peak. To move us through the valley of peace. That I seek. And as I experience a release of 3D attachment. I may watch its grand finale.
Surge through the collective.
Need to be.
need to be
in order to motivate this peak of the collective.
In order to motivate this peak of the collective.
And to inspire the collective.
And to inspire the collective.
To release attachments to the third dimension.
To release the attachments to the third dimension.
And move into greater 4D awareness.
And move into greater 4D awareness.
Doesn't mean we check out from our lives.
Doesn't mean we check out from our lives.
Doesn't mean we shut down.
Doesn't mean we shut down.
Doesn't mean we turn away from the world.
Doesn't mean we turn away from the world.
It means we spend less time.
It means we spend less time.
Obsessing.
Obsessing.
And using our imagination.
And using our imagination.
As a coping device.
As a coping device.
And allowing greater trust in the universe.
And allowing greater trust in the universe.
To be an opportunity.
To be an opportunity.
To step into greater alignment and communion.
To step into greater alignment and communion.
With the higher self that I am.
With the higher self that I am.
I am my higher self.
I am my higher self.
But it's in the process of being materialized.
But it's in the process of being materialized.
And actualized.
And actualized.
Into tangible physical form.
Into tangible physical form.
That's the journey I'm on.
That's the journey I'm on.
And in knowing it is so.
And in knowing it is so.
I allow all attachments to the 3D.
I allow all attachments to the 3D.
All attachments to repetitive patterning.
All attachments to repetitive patterning.
Obsessive thinking.
Obsessive thinking.
Fear-based superstition.
Fear-based superstition.
Any attachments to the spiritual ego.
Any attachments to the spiritual ego.
And any earthly or worldly programming.
And any earthly or worldly programming.
To be cleared out of my energy field once and for all.
To be cleared out of my energy field once and for all.
Return to the source of its origin.
Return to the source of its origin.
Transmuted completely.
Transmuted completely.
And heal to completion now.
And heal to completion now.
And from this moment forward.
And from this moment forward.
As a participant in my journey.
As a participant in my journey.
Not the controller of it.
Not the controller of it.
I let April be an opportunity.
I let April be an opportunity.
Where I don't have to be afraid of the lows.
Where I don't have to be afraid of the lows.
Or seduced by the highs.
Or seduced by the highs.
Because evolutionary cycles.
Because evolutionary cycles.
Starts with a clearing of sacred space.
Starts with a clearing of sacred space.
Or a death.
Or a death.
Before a new birth emerges.
Before a new birth emerges.
If it starts with death.
If it starts with death.
The only place to go is up.
The only place to go is up.
If I start at a birth.
If I start at a birth.
The only place to go is down.
The only place to go is down.
So it's okay to be open.
So it's okay to be open.
It's okay if I feel empty.
It's okay if I feel empty.
That's just the beginning of my awareness.
That's just the beginning of my awareness.
Being aware of the presence.
Being aware of the presence.
That goes from emptiness.
That goes from emptiness.
To the remembrance of light.
To the remembrance of light.
When I allow myself to be there.
When I allow myself to be there.
And may it be so.
And may it be so.
For all sentient beings.
For all sentient beings.
I am the ascension.
I am the ascension.
The ascension I am.
The ascension I am.
And so it is.
And so it is. And so it is.
Wow. How does that feel?
It feels spectacular. Yeah.
And something I wanted to add to that, just as we, you know, kind of round the corner in this beautiful energy update, is that it's no one's fault to be afraid of the lows and attached to the highs. That's part of the programming of the world. And I'm not even going to say that it's happening by diabolical purposes, because even if you can talk about the diabolical plan of the world or the agenda, even that was created by the universe to awaken consciousness on the world on the highest collective level, because that's the play of polarity. We need a low to birth a high, and sometimes a planet requires darkness to help us remember how brightly we shine. And so when I talk about earthly programming, on one level, human beings have been programmed to fear lows, to seek highs, and to project their unrequited love and their unresolved family traumas onto authority figures, including political figures, governments, and we sit around waiting for political mommy and daddy to make it all better. But this world is being shifted on a community level. And if we have to witness the breaking down of a monetary system, if we have to witness the breaking down of certain government structures to bring us back into community, the universe will do that. And so I say all of this, that this is an opportunity, when I say release through dimensional attachments, to wake up out of how we've been programmed. Because the program is, I'm paralyzed by the lows, I'm frustrated that I can't quite get to the highs as often as I want, so that I can project all of my neediness and all of my desperation onto an authority figure that I beg to rescue me. And those we beg collectively to rescue us imprison us, and it's done to wake us up. And so this is where the world starts to become aware that it's time to wake up out of imprisonment. We're not waiting to be rescued by political authority figures, and we're not waiting for spiritual authority figures to rescue us from political authority figures. Because if you want to know the true spiritual authority, you remember it and find it within yourself. And that's why this transmission and the work that Joy and I do moving forward is to bring you into full embodiment and into full availability of the powers of your higher self. For you are connected to the divine. You are divinity. But we have to actualize that into full remembrance so that you become an open window of light instead of a closed door of attachment, to bring all of what you are into this world. And so this is an opportunity to just witness the play of the world, to witness this broken, seductive pattern of programming that says, oh, things are getting a little intense. Don't you want to turn your attention towards a rescuer? A rescuer you either hope will rescue you, or a rescuer that you judge and talk about because they're not acting the way you want them to be. We're done with patriarchy. We're done with being enslaved, struggling, survival mode beings waiting to be rescued. We are remembering our divine origin. We are remembering our true nature. And we are here to remember that the tangible change we all want to see in the world will occur on a community level. And everything that's happening in the world is to turn us back towards community. And in order to do that, we have to first return home to the light within ourselves. We don't need to be rescued. We are here anchoring a planetary ascension. And when we spend less time afraid of the lows and less seduced by the highs, a master is reborn as you.
Thank you, my love.
I have, as you did the
last piece, as I just anchor this in, from the release of the patriarchy is also the release of the matriarchy. This is about sovereignty and not claiming the sovereignty to get there, but to just allow that ascension to be the sovereignty that anchors into this body. We are well on our way. Thank you so much for inviting me to be a part of this transmission today. I loved it very much. And I hope all of you loved this transmission as much as I did.
Thank you equally. joy for inviting me to be a part of this transmission with you. And thank you to everyone who is witnessing this energy update and all the updates and offerings that we provide. It's an honor to serve you. These are the times we've been waiting for. And whether they're exciting now or exciting later, I suppose is a matter of perspective, but we will be here with you every step of the way. We bow in your presence and we honor you as the light of truth, the love, present and alive in all. Until next time, namaste.